Have you ever wondered how those great speakers that you love to listen to have a conversational approach to their delivery? We're going to teach you how to have what's called an extemporaneous delivery style, coming up. Hello friends, I'm Alex Lyon and communication coach. This channel is here to help you increase your impact and lead your teams to higher levels of excellence. One of the ways you can do that is through better presentation skills. Today we're going to unpack how to speak extemporaneously, in other words, conversationally. Let's put it this way. Nobody wants to hear you give a memorized presentation. Nobody wants to listen to you read a presentation word for word. And here's how I know this. Do you want to listen to someone read a presentation word for word? Do you want to listen to someone like a robot give you a memorized word for word presentation? Nobody likes this. And unless you're president of the United States and you're using teleprompters, you probably won't ever be asked to do this in a professional setting. Almost everybody across the board that's at that high level of speaking uses what we call extemporaneous delivery style. And that means when you know the material so that you can speak conversationally with limited notes in a structured way. Now, it sounds pretty basic and you appreciate it when you see it, but it actually takes quite a bit of work to get there. But once you know how to do it this way, I doubt you'll ever want to go back to reading your notes word for word again. So first, let's talk about how to do this. The first tip is that you have to commit to a structure. The structure is the backbone of the whole presentation that helps you keep your place and helps you move forward according to your plan. You're going to need a really clear introduction, body, and conclusion. And within each of those sections, your introduction, for example, you're going to have certain parts that you hit, four parts of the introduction. You're going to know your clear two or three or four main points you're going to hit with nice transitions and information in each of those buckets. And you're going to have a really clear conclusion. You're going to know how you end. So you have to have a clear structure. If you don't have a clear structure, it's going to be very difficult to get comfortable enough to have a conversational style. The second tip is that you're going to have to practice probably more than you realize. I recommend practicing a presentation about 10 times. Now that might seem like a lot, however, over the years I've been doing coaching and teaching college for about 20 years in professional settings. It's really no different. If you only practice 2 to 3 times, you're just not gonna do that well. That's not enough repetitions to get completely comfortable with a topic, completely comfortable expressing yourself and connecting while you're sharing information. Time and time again, when I pull really skilled speakers aside, I say, yeah, about how many times you practice? The number 10 comes up a lot. Some people that are exceptionally gifted might only practice 8 or so times. Most people 10 or even more. So practice about 10 times. Now, the way you practice 10 times becomes really critical if you want to speak conversationally. Let's say the first time you practice, you use full set of notes. Now, the number one killer is too many notes. And so you want to pare down your notes to the bare minimum that you need to give that presentation. So you start off the first, and you, let's say you're practicing 10 times, the first 2 or 3 times you practice, you have your full set of notes. The more you practice, the more you should try to get away from that. Look up a little more often so that in the next 2 to 3 times you practice, I recommend cutting those notes about in half. So maybe you have, let's say you start off with 4 pages of notes, cut it down to about 2 pages of notes. And instead of full sentences, you want to pare it down to maybe half sentences. And then you practice it another 2 to 3 times. And then the last 2 or 3 times you practice, you should be all the way down to very simple bullet talking points that are just maybe even a single word or a short phrase. And the goal here is that as you're practicing that 8th, 9th, or 10th time, all you have to do is look at your notes just for a moment and you see maybe even one key word. Maybe it just says Hawaii. And you know you're going to tell a story about Hawaii that lasts about 30, 40 seconds. So now there's no reason to really look at your notes beyond glancing down, seeing the word, and putting your eyes back up on your listeners and connecting with them conversationally in that story about Hawaii. So you want to pare your notes way back and practice that way. So the next tip is each time you practice it, say it in a variety of ways. In other words, don't get locked in to using the exact same sentences, the exact same phrases each time you present. I even sometimes deliberately will say things differently each time I do it because it gives me another way to express it. In fact, a telltale sign for me when I'm watching a speaker and I can tell they're just memorizing this word for word is they might start a sentence a certain way and then not remember how to finish it. And so they'll go back and they'll start it over again a little differently so they can land at the end of the sentence the way they originally practiced it. That's gonna start to sound very robotic. You wanna say things in as many ways as possible when you're practicing so that in the moment, no matter what happens, you can move ahead in that presentation smoothly and still maintain that nice conversational approach. So practice it in a variety of ways. The other things you wanna do is keep your practice sessions realistic. Keep them real world. So for example, I like to, even though I'm alone when I'm practicing, oftentimes I like to look up away from my notes while I'm practicing because it's a good habit to get into to look up. So I practice only looking at my notes. Well, that's a habit I'm ingraining so that when I go to my actual presentation, I'm gonna have a habit of looking at my notes. So you wanna practice by looking up. Sometimes, in fact, and I know a good friend of mine actually set up stuffed animals and even put pillows inside of winter coats and put faces and paper on top of them. And then when they were practicing that presentation, they were looking at their stuffed animals and looking at those dummies they made. And during the presentation, it was much easier because they had practiced that way to connect because they made their practicing realistic. Now, obviously they're not real people, but maybe you have a roommate or even a dog that you can present to keep it real. Once you're really comfortable and you've kept it real, sometimes people will even add distractions. So they might turn the television on in the background or some music on in the background or do it in a somewhat public area. You might look a little crazy, but if you can present conversationally and get through your outline in a nice extemporaneous fashion, even with distractions, then you're much more likely to speak conversationally in the moment. You never know, for example, when there's gonna be someone outside with a jackhammer, someone outside with a lawnmower, someone's gonna come in late, someone's gonna leave early. In the moment, every little distraction can really heighten your nervousness and throw you off if you're not prepared for it. So the benefits of speaking extemporaneously cannot be underestimated. First of all, audiences prefer this style of delivery from presenters far and away. Nobody wants to hear you memorize or read your presentation. Believe me, you don't want to do it any more than you want to listen to it. And this is a skill that you can build on. If you can break the habit and get away from that safety net of all those notes, extemporaneous delivery, that conversational approach is a really great skill to build on. You can use it in all kinds of professional settings. You're gonna bring it with you for the rest of your life. So I highly recommend you take the plunge, pare those notes down to the bare minimum, and start practicing in a realistic way. So, question of the day, what are your tips for conversational delivery, for making things much more extemporaneous? I would love to hear your comments in that section below. So thanks, God bless, and I hope that you speak more conversationally in your very next presentation.